Hey, today I'm gonna put myself in a discomfort situation. I gotta go into the wild, find a place, make a shelter with a really reduced list of equipment. So all I have here is water, a firearm, my backpack, a fire kit, and inside my backpack, I have a hatchet, I have a warm jacket, and I have a sleeping bag. So if you wanna know more, you can watch the previous video when I made a complete list of what I have on myself when I go into the wild like this, and gonna give you a better idea of what you need to not put your life at risk while going into a discomfort situation. So follow me right now for this little adventure. I hope you're gonna enjoy it. Let's go. Just arrived to the top of this mount. So as you can see, it's pretty dry here. There is a gorgeous view everywhere around. But to spend the night, I should find a good spot that cover me from the wind. So actually there is a south wind coming from this way, shooting this way. And as you can see behind me, there are some trees and it goes a bit down. So I should be protected even from the east one. And the trees by themselves gonna protect me from the wind if the wind decides to come from the west. So I'm gonna go down, try to find a place, ideally with natural structure like a tree. And I see with that what I can do. And anyway, I'm gonna show you how it goes. So there we go. All right, so as you can see, I found the shelter for tonight. It's a great kind of pyramid structure. So I have the vertical one here that goes up, and I'm gonna put wood all along, cut those one here, really easy. And the wood that I can use that here, I can use it for the fire. And as you can see around me, it's quite covered. Even if there is a wind, it's gonna go over the rocks and not down here, so I'm protected from every directions, which is good to have a good night, because sometimes you can have a wind from nowhere coming in the middle of the night and waking you up, or just like making something with the fires, and we have to be careful with that too. It's semi dry today, it should not be really dangerous. It rained last couple of days, and anyways, it's as you can see, there is a lot of wood around, which is good because it helps me a lot in the mission of finding wood. And finding wood for the whole night, it can be really long. So it's a kind of priority, because now it's okay. So it should be okay for the night, even if it's around maybe 6-7 degrees. But when it's colder, unfortunately, you need more time, and then to get more woods, to get warm, to be warm all during the night. I should start to work on that, prepare the wood for the fire too, and prepare the shelter. Let's go. as you can see here, I prepare the fire. So I put small one in here, really dry one, after I go with a bigger size, and I continue to go bigger and bigger to have those long-term burning. So there I am, with that beautiful view behind me. It has been a good day, actually. So I made the shelter. It was actually really good to find, really easy to find the wood. It's a big process because, you know, you have to walk a lot around and you can lose energy. But anyways, the fire is ready to go. The shelter is good. I know there is no rain tonight. It's mostly to protect myself from the wind that can occur anytime. So with that saying, I'm just gonna chill, just enjoy, and at the same time enjoying the discomfort. That's why I'm here. I know it's maybe gonna be cold. My equipment is good, but still, you know, it's not at a mattress. It's not comfortable. I'm directly on the floor. I'm more considering the cold and the energy that I'm gonna lose. So anyway, guys, I go back to the shelter. I'm gonna start a fire pretty soon, and that's it. So yeah, guys, it's 6:30 now, and I just figured out that before starting the hike, I forgot my headlight, which is an important fact, you know, but that's why, and it's a good reminder to always have your EDC, your everyday carry, ready and on your body, you know, on yourself. Because now I have my flashlight here, I can use to get wood, or in case of emergency, I have to go down. I have light. I also have one on my rifle, but you know, it's easier to carry and normally on the head, and you can do two things at the same time. So just a good reminder, always have your EDC, and it can save you a lot of trouble. So ladies and gentlemen, this is how it looks like for the moment. The shelter and all the setup inside. There we go. So guys, temperatures are great for the moment. I'm gonna go to bed now. I'm gonna try to have the maximum sleep possible. The food, the fasting is great. Actually, I feel good. And I'm gonna see if the night's gonna be great too. Should be good, actually. So I see you tomorrow, and have a good night. So there I go. The night wasn't that comfortable. It was the main goal, actually. So, but the temperatures were quite good. A bit cold in the night, woke up a couple of times, maybe more. But the shelter did the job, didn't move at all. The fire just went out in the middle of the night, and no visit by any animals. Anyways, I always have the bear spray and the gun with me all the time. It's one of the rules you should keep, especially if you in some places like BC or Alberta. I talk about Canada. This is where you can encounter the most dangerous animals on this planet too. And yeah, look at that. This is one of the reason I wake up in the morning and in the nature really early, because you can have so much beautiful shows like that where you can just see the world waking up, animals, birds singing. You can also see the people from where you are. From here, I can see the people doing their life. It's something that is really appreciated. It reminds you, especially if sometimes you do a hike, you go over everybody, you see everybody that is tiny, and it reminds you that how tiny we are in this world, and that we have to replace ourselves in a good place. We're not over anything or anyone here. It's a war thing, you know, it's nature. And so something is really important about the discomfort. It makes you stronger. It makes you more resilient because you depend on nature, and you have to follow those rules. You know, it's really easy to fall into the comfort, like every day. All day long you can have it. You wake up in a soft bed, in a warm temperature room, and you go in the car and you can just choose the temperature you want, and you can drive, you can even estimate the time you're going to take to go to work or to go to the grocery stores. You can have food, like any kind of food in this world, you can have it just like that. You can even just call someone and it brings you food. You can have a warm shower every day, as many times you want. And that's something crazy that I think is today is normal for us, but it can break down anytime too. And if you don't train, if you don't put yourself in the discomfort, you will never know what are you capable of when everything is not made anymore to put you in discomfort. So I think it's really important to go back at it and to put yourself, to challenge you in those situations, to follow the rules of nature. That if it says it's cold, but you have to manage to do the best. And it's by practicing that you can know your equipment, you can know how you react to the cold, to the heat, how to react by the lack of water, the lack of food. I didn't eat, but I react pretty well. So sometimes I do it. So I think my body now is regulated about that. And I think it's really good. And you should do that, even if you don't go outside in nature. Yeah, food is like, you won't know how you react about that. And if it's just a fear, it's a fear. The fear is created by the mind too. And you have to confront the fear sometimes. And this is what is good in putting yourself in those situations. It's like jumping in the lake. It can be really scary to jump in the lake that is really cold. And, you know, I guess it's normal. But you have to go in that lake and put yourself in that situation where it's going to be cold, and you have to manage and control this cold and your body reaction. And after that, when you try it, at least if you try it, you're going to see that you can feel invincible. And that I can prove you, since the first time you do it, you're going to feel invincible. And you're going to be like, oh, it wasn't that bad. I would do it again. And then you do it again. I don't tell you that you should go and jump in the lake every day of your life. But if you can do it quite often, it's good, because it reminds your body that how strong it is. And even your mind, because everything that is related to the body is related to the mind. And I think it's really important to put yourself in those situations. You're going to know more about yourself. You're going to keep you away from depression, from regression. And you're going to know how strong you are in case of there is any kind of breakdown happening. Or if one day you just lose yourself while you're doing a hike and you don't have any cell phone signal. You know, you can't always rely on the government and any entities that is made to save your life. Sometimes it's just about you. And in everyday life basics, it's not just going in and going into the nature or jumping in a lake. It's also putting yourself in an uncomfortable situation, like having a difficult conversation with a relative or with your boss or with anyone in the street, like you're not sure. Just try it. Just go forward. Try it. And you're gonna see how capable you are. And I think it's good too, because instead of seeing the negative side all the time, you can see the positive side, what it can bring to you. And the uncomfort is bringing a lot of things. And you're gonna say, yeah, it's good, but it's good to have the good comfort and to be like that. Yeah, but one day you're gonna pay the price. You're gonna pay the price, like in a random situation when your life is at risk, or just later, when you're gonna be old and sick. Remember, our ancestors used to travel oceans and deserts with nothing, not a whisper of technology. And they went through the cold, through the heat, and through the lack of food and water sometimes, and they crossed continents and oceans. And now we can't even go for one night in nature for most of the people. I think there is a lack of responsibility somehow, and we should not forget that we are humans, and humans is a kind of animal, part of this world, not over the world. And the technology, yeah, it can help, but sometimes you have to go without, and you have to manage with just the basic of nature and the capabilities that is natural for us, but that we lose since years now, years and years. In the blink of an eye, we just lost everything. And there we go. You have to, nowadays, you have to put yourself back in those situations to feel it, to live it, and to learn from that to become the best person and the best version of yourself. All right, guys, this is the end of this video. I hope you enjoyed the video, all the advices and the mindset I can share to you. Just go challenge yourself, go outside, go take a cold shower, go into nature, go reconnect with yourself and the nature. I think it's really important. It doesn't mean put your life at risk. It just means, like, go outside, challenge yourself, become stronger, more resilient, and you could be proud of yourself if you do that. So I hope you're gonna do that. And for the rest, just give a share, a like, and follow us on social media for more content. So I hope to see you next time. Ciao, ciao.